there, Tins. Master Loopy Banana Muffin here, and welcome to LoopyCraft Episode 7. That is correct. The 7th episode of LoopyCraft. This is the farthest I've ever gotten on a series. Also, I feel a lot better than I did before. Got a lot of health, as you can clearly see. So, okay, let's go down here. And, yeah. There's my giant deformed torched holding statue that may also look slightly deformed. Got my seaport out that way. Got my seaport over there, I mean. Okay, I didn't think that. Oh well, I'm just gonna grab it, go right through. Alright. Come on, why can't I hit it? There we go. One of these things, I need to craft some shears. One of these, yeah, I do need to craft myself some shears. But as you can clearly see, I have, like, a lot of health. Granted, you can obviously tell that a player should not be able to have such a large number of health. But, yeah. Yeah. So just for the heck of it, like, just for the hey, I don't know. Hold on a second. Alright, there we go. I lowered my screen down a little bit so I can see what I'm doing. Right, so what's in here? Wait, what? Two gold blocks and a black banner with a yellow thing. Oh, it's the Mojang logo. Nice. Keep that handy. And then there's two blocks of gold. Where does gold stuff go? I'll put the gold blocks in here. As for the banner, I think I'll put that in here because that's pretty rare. I don't know who sent me that, but thanks. Okay, what am I doing? Oh, yeah. I put what's left of those blocks. Like, I did discard quite a few of them since I was technically cheating. So, yeah. Don't worry, it won't happen very often. So it looks like one thing I'm going to try doing is, wait a second. Oh, it's nighttime. Hang on. Alright, so first off, I'm gonna do a sleep so I can skip to dawn. And, yeah. Considering that I spawned, like, within the midst of an ocean biome. Like, I'm on an island in the middle of an ocean biome. You can kind of tell that there's a pretty messy situation right there. Wait, what block am I looking at? Oh. So, hang on. I'm going to go back in my base, or I could just mine a bunch of blocks out here. Preferably sand. I don't have to keep myself waiting. Actually, what's down? Ooh, I didn't even realize these were down here. So, I didn't even realize these were here. I think I've already got a specific cave system down somewhere. But I haven't really visited that one in forever. Speaking of which, let's go ahead and go that way. Wait. First off, let me light up this area in case there's more that I missed. Okay, I don't think so, but I'm going to leave the torch there anyway. So let's go back in my base. Let's open that. Oh, I did do something with that area because, yeah, why else would I have had all those ingots? Let me just find it real quick. Ah, here we go. I think it was down this way. Okay, go put that there. Oh, I may have just about tried to dig into water. Speaking of water, I eventually need to craft buckets to make an infinite water supply. Oh no. Hang on one second, I need to do something real quick. Alright, I'm back. So, yeah, I've been kind of doing stuff in my mind. And you get to see firsthand what I've been doing. So, yeah. I've been digging around. Oh, there's water nearby. What the? Yeah, I keep hearing water nearby, and I never seem to find it. So, yeah. There could be water, like, getting ready to, like, burst out and try to drown me again. But just in case. I don't want to try to overdo the whole digging idea. Wait, what's this down here? If anything. Nope, never mind. This is somewhere I've been before. And speaking of been here before... possible gravel warning. Ooh. Wait, hold that thought. I'm going to give myself a quick enchant. Sorry about the cheating. Yes, Fortune 3. It's a possible gravel warning for a reason. Like, I didn't necessarily want to do that, but I did anyway. Also, apparently my pickaxe is immensely OP. If you look at it closely, it does have enchantments. I mean, that should have been obvious from, like, several episodes ago. What you don't know is what's on said pickaxe, efficiency 10, making it practically diabolically fast, especially at breaking blocks. Granted, it's a little bit too much for my tastes. Honestly, I don't even know why I even gave myself the enchantment in the first place. It also made it unable to break. Oops. I may have just dug myself in. Alright. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move. I honestly need to change the pickaxe so that it has the same enchantment, but it does, but it breaks faster because of it. I don't want it to be too easy. And also, the reason why I gave my shovel a Fortune 3, well, here's your answer. Once again, like basically if I give myself like a massive bunch of enchants that would make the game otherwise unfair to my advantage. what I should probably do is make it unbreakable. Is instead of making it unbreakable, I just need to give it normal durability, and hopefully I won't wear it out like in an instant. It would be one heck of a challenge now that I think about it. And I'm not going to do it just yet, because I'm not going to die that quickly because of this. But yeah. So yeah, I don't know who sent me those two gold blocks in that banner. It's not Mojang, even though that's their symbol. Huh. I mean, I think what I'm going to do with said block eventually, I'll just combine that with the rest of my other gold. And I think I have apples, and you know where I'm heading with this. I may make some golden apples. Now, one thing I do want to do eventually is do some more tree farming so I can get rid of these godforsaken saplings. I think I've got birch in here too, but that's not as important. What is important is the fact that I have a crap ton of oak saplings that I want to get rid of. Also, just so I don't end up running out of space too soon. Now, the idea of that was to just clear out the excess. I cleared out the excess, stone. And by stone, it apparently refers to, like, andesite, granite, diorite, etc. Okay. Crap, I didn't mean to do that. So one thing I do want to do in this episode, preferably, is I'm going to build a platform out into the middle of the sea. And I may use a boat to go out and break like the blocks behind me. Hang on, I may have to sneeze. Okay. It went away for now, but just know that the threat is there. Anyway. With that being said, I'm going to build a platform out into the middle of the ocean, far away from my torches. And there's a reason for this, but I'm not going to share exactly what it is yet. What it involves is pretty freaking cool. I may actually extend my wall slightly so it doesn't necessarily completely block off the area that I'm planning, but I can still get to it properly, which actually I'm going to do that right now. So, for what I'm trying to do, the beginning area is what I want to fortify in specific. Actually, now that I think about it, hang on. One of them may have fallen down here somewhere. I don't know exactly what happened, but me. This will also give me a little bit of extra protection, like, on my actual island itself. Because then I'm not trying to avoid, like, mobs trying to kill me left and right. If there are any light gaps, yeah, no, there won't be light gaps. Once I have everything set up the way I want, I have an idea. But right now, I need to craft more, whatchamacallits. What did I do at the crafting table? There we go. So I need more walls. There we go. Give myself a good bunch of them. Wow, that was actually more than I thought. That was actually more than I thought it would be. Alright, so. We're going to go down here. We're going to go here. Although now that I think about it, I probably should have considered, like, a small gap here. And actually, I am going to have to eventually expand the seaport slightly this way so that I can still use that area, but I can actually go around the area and do what I'm going to do. Great, I'm giving myself cobblestone. I don't know what's wrong. I don't know why I would do that, but I'm doing it. And there's actually a specific, I gave myself cobblestone because apparently I'm about to just straight up hit a bottlenose where I won't be able to get through at all. Like, I'm trying to avoid, like, bottleneck situations like this where I can hardly get through or cannot get through at all. So I have to be expanding somewhat to make things a little more easy to get to what I'm doing. Alright, gonna go over here. Hit that. Definitely hit here. Alright, gonna go here. Ah, I made a bottlenose. Alright, hang on 1 second. Bam, fixed. There is actually something in specific, but I'm not gonna tell you what it is just yet. Although, once I get it finished, completely finished, you'll see what I'm doing, and it's gonna be awesome. Okay, so I didn't realize I would have to get behind this wall to be able to build. Be able to build some extra stuff. I may have to end up. Yeah, I'll have to end up swimming. Alright, so one other... okay. I think out here will be fine. Because it's a decent ways away from my base. I might be able to do this. I don't know. We're just gonna have to find out. I may have to also dig up some of the walls, and some of them might fall in the water and never be found again. I did not think this through completely. Alright, so we're just... I don't think we have enough cobblestone to finish this area exactly. But we'll have to come back to this later in a future episode. I mean, I'm not saying it's over just yet. I do have more stuff I'm trying to do in specific. I think right here is where I'm going to set up what I'm doing. But I don't have enough cobblestone to finish this exact area. Actually, hang on. Let me go back and try to find some cobblestone. Or I could probably mine it out from the immediate vicinity. And I don't want to end up hitting my base exactly because, yeah, then I'll end up messing stuff up. Here's a touch of cobblestone. And I almost didn't give myself way back up. Well, this is fun. Okay, so now I've got like a fourth of a stack and then a full stack of cobblestone. It's a decent amount. I've given myself ample opportunity. So I guess from what I'm doing, it looks like it's some kind of, okay, I don't want that there in specific. And now I'm swimming very slowly. There we go. All right, I'm back up. Actually, wait a second. I need planks because that seaport, I mean, think about it this way. The seaport I have in mind. When I had the seaport in my head, the idea was, well, to have somewhere to launch boats from, be able to explore the surrounding area. All right. Move over this way. So I'm going to expand the launch area, which is why the planks were there in the first place. So now, not only does that give me a way into the arena, but now that also gives me a specific area to launch my boats from. The open ocean is no laughing matter, but I will make it a laughing matter by crossing the ocean. Well, not completely crossing the ocean. I do want to be, well, here now because I've got too much built. That means so much to me. I mean, I don't know how much I consider a giant statue of myself that looks kind of like Lady Liberty, although it's me. And considering the fact that it's Minecraft, yeah. It's Minecraft and I look really awful, apparently. Oh well, can't win them all. So, in specific, what I'm trying to do I'm going to edit this area real quick that I didn't think about. Give myself some decent space. Like, seriously, there's a weird jut that cuts off my movement and it just sucks. But, yeah. So what I'm probably going to end up doing is doing a raised platform on which I'll grow trees. And actually, there's something specific I'm doing to do this. I may need to get more dirt somewhere. That's not where I want my dirt. Also, I'm gonna put this there because I do need a way back down. So now we're gonna go back in the base. I hurt myself sometimes. Ow. Gonna see where the ladders. Well, I have a lot of dirt apparently. This is perfect. I can do this. Actually, should I craft more ladders? I don't know. We'll see soon enough. Now, the ladders are to provide a safe way for me to get around the base. And yeah. So actually, the giant deformed torch on Loopy Liberty, as I dubbed the guy. Specifics of this thing. Okay, so I didn't really need a bunch of ladders, but anyways. So what I'm gonna do is build a raised platform. I'm hoping not to make it super huge, because I do have to somehow light it so that A, the trees will grow faster, and B, so the mobs don't spawn underneath and start wreaking havoc. I think mob griefing is off, but just in case, I need to somehow light this puppy up. All right. I think considering how far we've come, how little I've been trying. Well, never mind. You can kind of tell I've been cheating to get this far. I would have preferred though not to. But well, I can't help myself. So, okay, so to start off my tree farm, I'm going to place a bunch of saplings. And this one in specific, I'm going to move in one because I have a better idea for what I want to do with these. I'm going to put torches in the corners and one right by the ladder area. So there we go. That's a raised platform right there. Also, I'm going to put two on each side of this block here. I think they're on the same block. Yes, they're on the same block. And, yeah. The area looks great. So, one thing I'm going to do before I wrap up this episode, because apparently it's gone to about 30 minutes, is I'm going to craft a few fence. Not fence, but fence gates. Yeah, there we go. Let's go right here. Put that there. And, yeah. I'll give myself two fence gates, and yeah, let's get down here again. Bam, move that, and bam. Now I have a way to Loopy Liberty and potentially the rest of my base. So I have a way to Loopy Liberty, and I have a way in progress to get to that area over there. All I'm just going to go ahead and put those cobblestone down there. Switch to the wall so I can connect the fence gate I built. Oops. Hang on. There we go. Move that. And now out there should be something. I may have to expand it so that the mobs will spawn. But yeah. And yeah. I think that just about wraps up what I'm trying to do. Hang on, one more thing. I'm gonna put my saplings back over here because sugarcane's not part of that area. Put the sticks back. Planks, ladders, dirt. Put the dirt back that was left over. I think cobblestone goes there. So, and these, I think I'm just gonna get rid of that in specific. Sandstone, gonna throw that in. Iron ore, cobblestone wall. I have plenty of flint. In fact, I have like over a stack and a half. And yeah. Put wool, mushrooms. I think mushrooms are over here. And actually, that one in specific is the brown mushroom. The red mushroom I really want to try to grab later on. Although I'm not sure where those are at. And yeah. One more thing. I'm going to clear stone, which will delete the andesite from my inventory. Actually, those blocks are actually kind of useless for what I usually do. And, yeah. I don't really have any valuable things yet. I have plenty of lapis. And eventually, I'll have to try and create, obsidian, so... Oh, but I need more diamonds. Oh, crap. So, what I'm gonna need is more diamonds. And then I'm going to need lava, which I haven't really located yet. And, yeah. But, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. That's a big close-up of my face. And if you enjoyed the series, be sure to like and subscribe. Because apparently, that's something that should be done. Yeah, but, yeah. Like I said, like and subscribe, and I'll be back to you sometime in the near future. Bye!